whether actually we don't have time. Don't have time. So I'm trying to integrate it, and I have sympathy with him. I couldn't do this if I was working. I couldn't accept even the invitation to speak at a conference. So I'm integrating for you, but these are not surprises to you, right? You have read somewhere in a literature, newspaper, but I'm just your organizer. So what does it mean for you as an individual actually? Because you must be taking accountability for what you do so that you can remain as an economic actor as you go forward in the next 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, right? So I need to take a short nap as we go into the next section. Because we'll talk about the challenge for individual actuaries, right? How should I start? So what do we do, man? What do we do? Because professionally you must do something which other people cannot do. What do you do? Which gives the company pay you well? And why do you start to be an actuary? Apart from interest and all that, huh? But really, what do you do on this crisp value? What is so special about actuaries? Quite happy, right? Family have a celebration when you go to FIA and all that, right? What is so special? I feel what is so special about you, okay? And I spoke, I thought about this for a long time. Copywriter. Okay, so there's something called skills and methods, okay? Skills and methods, okay? So these are things you know, but math and statistics, risk and stochastic, investment and economies, combined risk and life contingency, especially computation function. But you are not as good as the mathematicians, we're not as good as the pure mathematicians, we're not as good as the statistician, but we're not good as the investment people or the risk people, the pure people. When we come to compound interest, we're very good. The accountants think that they also know accountants, but they don't really truly understand. And the CFA are not bad, the dividend discount model and all that, but you show them increasing entity, decreasing entity, redemption, coupons, they're all bank son. They cannot be right. So we are quite special. But more special is the life table. But life table statistician, especially if you study demography, is not a big deal. LXS is not a big deal. But we combine LXS with interest rate, you know, and call it computation function. We are untouchable. No other profession understands computation function. No other profession understands computation. And that is the science we've built on for the last 150 years in UK and US. That is what is unique about us. That's all. And we interplay with where we work. And 95% of us, 95% of us work in an insurance company or a reinsurance company in pensions, GI, investment, and consulting regulation. All of you. Yeah. Some of us in technical roles, some of us in general manager role, but there is a distinction we'll talk about later. But what was special was that we were using commutation function and interest rate, right? And we have basically to do annuities. This is 100 years ago by Richard Price, and we're doing annuities, James Austin. Yeah. And then we have a big profits product, reversionary bonus, terminal bonus, net premium valuation, bonus reserve valuation, and then mismatching reserves. Then we go into pensions, right? Final salary scheme, deferred annuities, you know, and funding. No one can touch us. No one can touch us because we are the only one you can do. Because profession is partly about skills and method, but also we have shared standards, shared contexts, shared languages, shared practices. And we were trusted because we tell the insurance company how the price, how the value. Government says, okay, you must be an FIA. Therefore, they only can certify. So therefore, it creates a demand for a qualification so the industry thrive. And all of us, right? I first, right, earlier, I went to join, you know? Because same as the pure boss. Once you get it, you are set for life. And all of you follow. You did independently, right? I'm going to say it's a pill box. Because I use the word mentality. Because when somebody wanted a good job, they want a great job, right? So my wife asked me, say that, actually, our son, a young son, to be an actuary. And when a woman asks you, should my son be an actuary or a doctor, what they mean is that, will he get a good job? A secure job for the rest of his life. I don't think he's interested in mathematics, you know? Yeah, so that was, I think, if you want to understand, you better come to the presentation because it's a complex question, right? Depends on what you want. And it applies to all kinds of professions. Yeah? So where are you now? Okay, there was a group of actuaries, I need to share this with you. There was a group of actuaries led by Sidney Benjamin, Professor Robert Beard, and G.D. Hay. They were in the UK, right? And they start saying, I just joined the profession, that we, actuaries must go to GI, General Insurance, and tell them they need us. But actually, we have really nothing to offer. we can accept our reputation as mathematicians because our mathematics are very simple. The most complicated mathematics we had was something called chain ladder method, which is really not a big deal, right? But we had a reputation, we got standard, we can look at data and join the dots and say your outstanding claim should be done more systematically, your UPR, and then we are adjacent. Today, about 3,000, 4,000 entries in the UK work in the GI industry. And some of our earlier pioneers were like that. They went into investments, yeah? So they went to asset value machine, and therefore the profession grew throughout the world. But we made some mistakes in the last 25 years. Advances in financial economics, we talked about volatility markets. We were unable to cope. We were never using the techniques of corporate finance and advanced financial economics to look at pricing. And we're using net premium valuation and to look at the kind of reserve required for guarantees in energy and also with profit products and unit-linked products. And there was a huge debate, and as a result, we were on the back foot. And we shouldn't be in the front foot by incorporating the advances of financial economics into our syllabus. But eventually, we got it back through CERA. But it cost the profession dear. It cost us Equitable Life, where people like Richard Price and William Morgan came from, but it also cost our reputation, and therefore we were heavily regulated.